हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज पूनम भंडारे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ तुलसीराम जी गायकवाड़ पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी नागपुर। इन टुडे सेशन वी हैव टू सी दी सेंसर नेटवर्क आर्किटेक्चर। सो सेंसर नेटवर्क आर्किटेक्चर इज यूज इन अ वायरलेस सेंसर नेटवर्क। इट कैन बी यूज इन वेरियस प्लेसेस लाइक स्कूल, हॉस्पिटल, बिल्डिंग्स, रोड्स एक्सेट्रा फॉर वेरियस एप्लीकेशन लाइक डायस्टर मैनेजमेंट, सिक्योरिटी मैनेजमेंट, क्रिसिस मैनेजमेंट एक्सेट्रा। सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द वे दैट डेटा आर कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम वेरियस सोर्सेज, वायरलेस सेंसर नेटवर्क कैन बी क्लासिफाइड इंटू थ्री टाइप्स। फर्स्ट इज द होमोजीनियस सेंसर नेटवर्क, सेकेंड इज द हेट्रोजीनियस सेंसर नेटवर्क एंड थर्ड वन इज द हाइब्रिड सेंसर नेटवर्क। एंड इन होमोजीनियस सेंसर नेटवर्क वी हैव द टू टोपोलॉजी, फर्स्ट इज द फैट टोपोलॉजी एंड सेकेंड इज द हिराचिकल टोपोलॉजी। So this is the basic structure of wireless sensor network. So there are the n number of sensors nodes or cluster members that sit at the particular cluster head. We have assigned the sensor nodes with a cluster head, and that cluster head sit at the particular base station. So this is the basic architecture of sensor network and the wireless sensor network. In this there are the three-way communication, that is the sensor node to cluster head to base station. So this is the wireless sensor network. First type is the homogeneous sensor network. A homogeneous network consists of a base station and the node. This is the general architecture of homogeneous sensor network, and it consists the base station and sensor node equipped with equal capabilities, for example computational power and storage capacity. So data gathering in this type of network is based on the structure of data dissemination. In homogeneous network we are used the two topology, first is the flat and the hierarchical topologies are the two representative structure being widely studied for data dissemination and gathering in homogeneous network. So in a flat network or flat topology, data aggregation is accomplished by data centric routing, where the base station usually transmit a query message to the sensor node. So by using the flooding, and the sensor node that have data matching the query will response message back to the base station. The sensor node communicate with the base station via multi-hop routing by using peer nodes as relays. The choice of particular communication protocol depends on the specific application. First figure on left hand side, it shows the flat network architecture. The sensor nodes are assumed to be a stationary ones being distributed in a targeted area, and the collected sensing information is gathered at the base station. There is a direct communication to the sensor node to base station. In a hierarchical network, on right hand side there is a hierarchical architecture. Sensor nodes are organized into cluster, where the cluster heads serve as simple relay for transmitting the data. Since the cluster heads have the same transmission capacity as the sensor node, the minimum requirement on the sensor of clusters can be derived from the upper bound of the throughput. Higher throughput can be achieved by using clustering at the cost of having extra node function as cluster heads. So in hierarchical network we have formed a cluster, that is the we formed a cluster by the, in cluster there are the 100 or more than 100 nodes are there. So each cluster we have assigned the particular cluster head. That means that sensor nodes or that cluster member send it to the particular that cluster head, after that cluster head send it to the particular base station. So in this, data aggregation in a hierarchical network involves data fusion at cluster head, so which reduce the number of messages transmitted to the base station. In a hierarchical we have avoid the traffic, because number of sensor nodes send to the particular base station cluster head, and that cluster head to the particular base station. So and it improves the energy efficiency of the network. So this is the homogeneous network. Second is the heterogeneous network. So in heterogeneous sensor network, it consists of base station, that is the fixed and mobile sensor nodes, and sophisticated sensor node with advanced embedded processing and communicating capabilities as compared to normal sensor nodes. In this, data gathering can be executed at the mobile base station. In each network, mobile base station move randomly in the area of the deployed network, collecting data directly from the sensor nodes or use some surrounding sensor nodes to relay that data. So sometimes, for example, sometimes sensor nodes may be distributed sparsely and the distance between any two sensor nodes can be far apart. So the long distance among sensor node implies the more energy will be consumed for communication. Meanwhile, sensor nodes need to perform sensing and communication for as long as possible. So in the particular in heterogeneous network, there is an additional node, that is this node is known as the mobile terminal or mobile base station. So data gathering is the main process to in the heterogeneous network to prolong the lifetime of the system. So this is the heterogeneous network. Last one is the hybrid network. So in a hybrid sensor network, several mobile base stations work comparatively to provide fast data gathering in a real-time manner. So in the scenario shown in the figure, collected data will be relayed by several mobile base stations. The conventional and well-studied routing algorithm for ad hoc networks can be adopted as a routing protocol among these mobile base stations. So mobile ad hoc network, that is the MANET, assume that every node is able to move at their own pace. So even though WSN are some constrained than other wireless network, for example, sensor nodes in terms of energy, processing, transmission, range and bandwidth, routing from a source base station to a destination base station can be accomplished by using MANET protocols in hybrid sensor networks. So hybrid sensor network can achieve longer lifetime and it also improves the efficiency of data gathering. So hybrid network is the best wireless sensor network in which we can improve the energy efficiency and we can increase the network lifetime. So this is the all about the hybrid network. So thanks to all of you for watching this video. Thank you.